Such person should be put into maximum emergency, compensatory, solitary, that's in parenthesis, confinement. Now, what do I mean by, you call it an emergency because it is. It's a maximum emergency when you unjustly, willfully, deliberately, maliciously kill another person. And underline that, unjustly, not talking about self-defense. Talking about you had malice and you willfully and deliberately killed another person on account of you just felt like you wanted to do it. You have a beef or whatever, all right? So you should be put into maximum emergency because this is an emergency. Anytime you kill people, you're talking about an emergency. This is no small thing. We take it as a small thing because the white supremacist has made a world where killing is supposed to be fun. Killing is something that's glorified. You have reenactments of battlefields and all like that. People dress up. And people go to what we call video games, I understand, and play all kinds of, you know, blowing up things with people in them and seeing people burned alive and all that type of thing. And so, you know, a young person sitting there looking at that, they grew up with a steady diet of killing is fun. Boy, I mean, you know, bang, 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 and watching somebody fall down bleeding. So you put a person who does that unjustly into that solitary confinement, and I described that early on, but I want to add a few things.
Okay.
You know, you don't talk to anybody except, and I said this before, once you go into that solitary confinement, now how will they know from day to day, since they're feeding you through a trap door and you're not talking to anybody and nobody talks to you, and the only person or the only thing you talk to is the weapon that you use because that's the only thing in there with you, okay? Now, so suppose you die in there because you do kill yourself. How do they know you're dead? Well, for one thing, the food tray doesn't come back. That's an indication. So they'll wait several days or a couple of weeks, whatever time is set, and when the food tray doesn't come back, I mean, you don't get food until the tray comes back. So, therefore, they can assume that they can open it now, and you have met your match. Your match being yourself. See, nobody should be paid to kill another person. This thing of what we have set up now, of lethal injection and all like that, and people sitting, spectators sitting on the other side of a glass, watching it and all that. No, that's making a sport out of killing. Stop and think about it, folks. That's making some kind of sport. People come in and take a seat. I mean, and look and see the person being executed. And you sometimes you even have a religious person there. I mean, you know, officiating over it or saying a few words and all like that. I mean, what is this? That's real primitive. I mean, that's absurd. If you stop and think about it, logically speaking, I always say follow the logic. The constructive result is the law of compensation. People should understand all over the world that you should get what you put out. That's what you call the law of compensation. When you go out on a farm and you put seed in the ground, you expect to get a return on your investment. You put seed in the ground and then the oranges come up. The watermelon comes up. Yes, watermelon. Right. An excellent food. The white supremacists have us laughing at people that eat watermelon. It ain't nothing to laugh at about a watermelon. Watermelon is one of the best foods you can eat. Okay? I just wanted to throw that in there.
Okay.
But
all
you
right.
Get compensated by going out and working. Farmers understand that. That's why farmers don't like nonsense talk. If you ever talk to a real farmer, farmers don't have time for nonsense because they deal with what? They deal with the natural order of things. The white supremacists are always trying to get people to get away from the natural order of things.
Mm-hmm.
They'll say one of the natural orders is people killing people. No, that's an artificial thing that they keep pushing, and we should get out of that.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
Yep. That whole thing. And so I'm just saying, you stay in in there until you kill yourself, because that's what you should do. You took something away from here. You should take yourself away. Oh. On to that, talking about apologies now. Sometimes a person is asked to apologize in court, apologize to the family. No, you apologize to the person that you killed.
But they're dead.
Yes, but it's only one way to do that.
And that's
you got to go where they went. You got to go. If you're going to apologize to the person that you killed, you got to go where that person went.